Periodontal disease is a common yet serious condition that affects the gums and bones supporting the teeth. For dental professionals, the early detection and accurate diagnosis of this disease are critical to preventing tooth loss and managing oral health. The process of periodontal diagnosis and examination involves a comprehensive evaluation of the gums, measuring pocket depths with a periodontal probe, assessing any clinical attachment loss, and identifying signs of inflammation, such as bleeding on probing. Let's discuss the two key diagnostic tools in periodontal health: the Community Periodontal Index of Treatment Needs, or CPITN, and the Periodontal Screening and Recording, also known as PSR. First up is the CPITN, developed by the World Health Organization, or WHO. This serves as a broader purpose. It is primarily used in epidemiology to gauge periodontal disease prevalence and severity across populations. Periodontal probing is done using a WHO probe. The mouth is also divided into sextants. This involves examining specific index teeth in each sextant. These are the 1-7, 1-6 and 1-1 on the upper right, the 2-6, 2-7 on the upper left, the 3-7, 3-6 and 3-1 on the lower left, and finally the 4-7 and 4-6 on the lower right. The focus is on these teeth to assess the overall periodontal health of each sextant, primarily for population level surveys. Scores ranging from 0 to 4 reflect the severity of periodontal issues and treatment needs for each sextant. On the other hand, we have periodontal screening and recording, or PSR. This tool is a clinical adaptation of the CPITN, designed specifically for individual patient screenings, and this is probably the more relevant one. In contrast to CPITN, PSR involves examining all the teeth in each sextant, providing the more comprehensive individual assessment. It uses a similar 0 to 4 scoring system, focusing on the immediate periodontal care required for the patient. In PSR, the dentist uses a WHO probe, which is a probe notable for its 0.5 diameter ball at the end and a marked band between the 3.5mm mark and the 5.5mm mark. The oral professional divides the mouth into 6 sextants and examines each one, using the probe to gently assess pocket depths around each tooth at 6 specific sites: mesiobuccal, midbuccal, distobuccal, mesiolingual, midlingual, and distolingual. The deepest pocket depths recorded at each of these sites determines the score of each sextant, ranging from 0 for healthy gums to 4 for severe periodontal issues. This methodical approach with the WHO probe ensures a precise and comprehensive periodontal assessment. In the PSR system, each sextant is assigned a code based on the examination findings. These correspond to specific treatment recommendations. Code 0 indicates healthy gums with no treatment required. Code 1 suggests bleeding on probing with no calculus and the black band on the probe is visible. Patients in this situation should be educated on improving oral hygiene practices, including proper brushing and flossing, with regular checkups being an essential monitor for progress. Code 2 reveals calculus or factors hindering proper examination, but the black band is still visible, meaning that pockets are less than 3.5mm. Patients should undergo professional dental cleaning or debridement to remove calculus and plaque buildup. Alongside this, oral hygiene instructions should be provided for at-home care. Now, code 3 indicates a pocket depth of 3.5 to 5.5mm and a partially visible black band on the probe. A comprehensive periodontal examination is necessary. This may include scaling and root planing to remove the calculus deposits from the root surfaces. Patients should be scheduled for follow-up and maintenance to monitor the progress through periodontal examination. Code 4 is used when pocket depths are greater than 5.5mm and the black band is not visible on the probe. If there is a PSR of 4 in a sextant or multiple sextants, a thorough periodontal assessment such as a full mouth periodontal chart is required. Depending on the severity, surgical interventions such as flap surgery or bone grafts may also be required. Scaling and root planing should be performed, followed by ongoing maintenance to manage the condition effectively. Now there's an additional layer. If you have an asterisk next to a code, this denotes the presence of specific conditions that need further investigations, regardless of the numerical code. The asterisk might indicate different factors, like furcation involvement, mobility, mucogingival problems, or recession. To further assess these, radiographic imaging is required, and that can include bite wings, OPGs, or CBCTs. Periodontal charting is performed to assess furcation involvement, and bacterial testing may also help to identify the periodontal pathogens. Code X is used when the sextant is not scorable, for instance, if it contains fewer than two teeth. This code helps in indicating that the sextant was not applicable for standard PSR scoring due to unique circumstances. To summarize, periodontal disease affects the supporting structures of teeth, necessitating early detection and management. The examination includes measuring pocket depths and assessing signs of inflammation. Two key diagnostic tools are CPITN, which is used for epidemiological studies, and PSR for individual patient screening. CPITN focuses on specific index teeth per sextant, while PSR examines all teeth in the sextant. PSR uses a scoring system to guide treatment, ranging from oral hygiene instructions to potential surgery based on the severity of the periodontal conditions identified. In essence, these diagnostic methods are vital for proactive management of periodontal health, allowing dental professionals to tailor treatments to individual patient needs and effectively combat the progression of periodontal disease.